Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to a special telecast here on NewsX. What we are about to tell you is going to be news that is going to come as a wave that is going to go all across the world. It seems almost innocuous, but the magnitude of this moment is something special indeed. For 80 years in this country, we could not make a jet fighter. We could make a nuclear bomb. We could send a lander to orbit the moon. But we could not make a jet fighter because all the forces in the world, internal and external, did not want us to. 2 days ago, one of my colleagues, our strategic affairs editor, Ashish Singh, rode, flew, took part in a mock sortie on the Tejas that we have built. Well, guess what? The stealth mode is now ending. For the first time in full public domain, we have as many details as we can share with you on India catching up and going straight to the top of technology with a sixth generation fighter aircraft under development. Now, this is being put together by the Aeronautical Development Agency, the ADA, and its chief, Dr. Girish Deodhare, is now talking to us in this full detailed interview on what this sixth generation fighter may be with unmanned technology, twin engine. What's it going to be like? Listen in.
The poster boy of Make in India in defense and Atmanirbhar Bharat in defense, LCA Tejas, the same fighter jet that I flew yesterday, has seen a fantastic evolution from 80s, and it's been more than 3 decades since the time the light combat aircraft, the very own fighter jet of India, has been in a tremendous and rapid rate of improvement. And just to give our viewers exactly how proud we all should feel that India has its own fighter jet and is rapidly developing, I want to show you exactly in terms of evolution how this evolution is taking place. For example, this fighter jet you see, the scale model, this is the light combat aircraft Tejas Mark 1. The second one my cameraman will show you is the Mark 1 for the Navy. The third one will pan left, and the one you see, LCA Air Force, that's the Air Force's Mark 2. The fourth one is slightly right. The larger structure you see is AMCA, which is going to be the fifth generation fighter jet. And the fifth one that we'll now show is the scale model of the Indian Navy's deck-based twin-engine fighter jet, and this is obviously in the developing stage. Now, this is how tremendous improvement and the evolution LCA has seen, and there can't be a bigger location than Aero India to talk about it, and there can't be anyone better than the director, Dr. Girish Deodhare, director for the Aeronautical Development Agency of India. He's someone who has been involved in as far as the evolution is taking place. Dr. Deodhare, thank you for speaking to NewsX. And before we start and talk about each of these steps and the models so that our viewers get an understanding of how LCA has progressed in terms of evolution, give a brief to our viewers about the entire project and how it has evolved.
Okay. India's first fighter aircraft, which many people may not know, happened in 1961. This was the HF-24 Marut, which was a second generation aircraft. Unfortunately, after that, there was no development for more than 20 years in the aerospace domain. And in 1983, some senior experts like Professor Narasimha and at the government level decided that we have to revive this ecosystem in the country. ADA was formed in 1985 as a nodal agency for developing this class of aircraft. It was felt that no single agency had that expertise, so we had to form a nodal separate agency called ADA in 1985. In 88, the feasibility report for LCA was prepared. And at that time, the government realized that many technologies were not available in the country and were at a very nascent stage. So it was decided that we'll first sanction a technology development program, which was in 1993. This was the technology development, the TD aircrafts as they were so called. The TD-1 flew in 2001. So when TD-1 flew in 2001, that is when the technology that reached some level of maturity, that is when the government gave the order for developing this operational aircraft, IOC and FOC. That came in 2001. And as you know, in 2013, we had IOC. And now we are also into Mark 1A, which is beyond the FOC aircraft with additional capabilities. So this has been the long history. And Tejas is not just an aircraft. It is these technologies, these core technologies that take us to the forefront of aerospace design in the country. These are also carried in this aircraft. And these have got matured in this aircraft. So it's much more than just an aircraft.
Much more than just an aircraft. And I experienced it. I flew LCA Tejas in a rare opportunity. And trust me, the way it has been developed, it's certainly in almost all the parameters, nowhere less as compared to any other Western fighter jet. And whatever is left, it's obviously the work in progress. And we are certainly going to witness, as far as the later stages of the and the models of LCA is concerned, we are going to be in next 5-6 years, in my opinion, we are going to be at par as far as most of the Western fighter jets are concerned. So now, without much ado, let's talk to Dr. Devdare on each of these models. Dr. Devdare, if you can explain to our viewers exactly how different each of these models are, starting with the Tejas Indian Air Force Mark 1.
Yeah, so Tejas Mark 1 was planned as a replacement for the MiG-21 class of aircraft. Okay. But it is not a MiG-21. Okay. It was the vision of people like Dr. Kalam, who said that we have to make futuristic technologies available in this aircraft, which were not there in the country at all. We didn't know the ABC of many of those technologies, and that is what was developed. So this aircraft is unstable. Very unstable. It has got a time to double of 200 milliseconds. What that means is, if you get a perturbation of 1 degree, in 200 milliseconds it doubles. Okay. So effectively in 1 second it can become 32 times. So 1 degree can grow to 32 times. So this is the kind of instability this aircraft has. And obviously it can't be flown by a human being. He doesn't have that kind of reaction. So it needs an electronic flight control system, a digital fly-by-wire flight control system to control this aircraft at all times. Okay. And then the pilot flies this very stable and very smooth aircraft when it takes over. This has got composite structures. About 90% of the weighted area of this aircraft is composites, and 45% by weight, which is one of the largest in the world. So this was a new technology again developed in the country, which is useful for many programs subsequently, including space. Then it has digital avionics. It has many, many such new technologies, which are 4.5th generation, which are the core and state-of-the-art technologies today.
This is how LCA Mark 1 for the Air Force looks like. How different is the LCA Navy Mark 1?
Yes. So now a naval aircraft is a bigger challenge than an Air Force aircraft. The LCA itself was a challenge with all these technologies. But a naval aircraft has to do all that LCA Air Force can do, as well as land on that small ship in the sea, which is moving, and also take off from that ship. And that requires a lot of additional capabilities. Okay. So after TD-1 flew in 2001, the Indian Navy came out and said that let's try to make a technology demonstrator for the carrier, which very few countries have done in the world today. I mean, many countries make aircrafts for the Air Force, but for the Navy, it's a new technology. So what was decided was we'll take a Tejas trainer, which you flew yesterday, and modified. So we made two prototypes for the naval capabilities. So this aircraft is a strengthened aircraft, because on the ship it has to land with very high sink rates, plus the decelerations are very high once it catches the arresting wire. So the structure has to be strengthened. The undercarriage has to be... Undercarriage is bigger and it's strengthened. It's not shown here. But the undercarriage is also bigger and strengthened. It has got a new control surface. This is so-called LEVCON. This is so that it can approach the ship at low speeds for landing on the ship, because the wire only has so much strength. Mm-hmm. And so these technologies were proven. And to prove these technologies was also a challenge, because unlike the Air Force aircraft, you can't go to a runway and just try it out. Yeah. Going to a ship with a new aircraft requires assurance that you are not going to damage the ship, because that's a very high value asset. So for this, a special facility was built in Goa called the shore-based test facility, where the ship was replicated on ground. All the equipment on the ship, the arresting wire, the ski jump takeoff, everything is replicated on the ground. And we did years of trials on this. More than 400 to 500 landings were done there, high sink rate landings, and more than 50 takeoffs. in all kinds of conditions, night, day and so on, before the Navy got convinced that now we are ready to go to the carrier. And in January 2020, that was achieved successfully when this aircraft landed on the carrier. We did 18 landings and takeoffs in 5 days. And the beauty of that was we didn't miss the wire even once. This arresting wire is like a needle in the haystack. Yeah. You have to come and catch it from a distance. We didn't miss it even once.
Wow.
And that was the beauty of the flight controls, which was optimized for that.
Okay, so that's how the journey and the story of...
The technology demonstrator for the naval carrier aircraft.
Fantastic. When do we see this progressing further as far as the service is concerned?
That is already
we'll talk about it at the fifth evolution stage. Let's move to the third fighter jet, which has been the talk of the town as far as the entire LCA Air Force Mark II is concerned. There you see something that the entire Indian Air Force is looking forward to. And when we have these kind of steps taking place, something that the entire country would be excited about. Sir, explain to our viewers that how different this is as compared to the Air Force Mark 1 that we explained to our viewers, the evolution stage 1.
See, Air Force Mark 1 is a replacement for the MiG-21 class of aircraft, light aircraft, which are mainly for air defense, which work mainly within the boundaries of the country or just across. Whereas this is a much more capable aircraft, consolidating the Tejas technologies. Whatever technologies have been developed over the last two decades for Mark 1, are consolidated into this bigger, more capable platform, which is actually a replacement for the Mirage 2000 class of aircraft.
Okay.
But it is much more than that because it has more advanced technologies built in
here. Something that is visible here in terms of models that you can...
I'll explain. So this aircraft carries much more payload. Okay. The Tejas carries 3.5 tons of payload, that is weapons. This can carry 6.5 tons.
Okay.
It's almost double. It can carry much more fuel. Mm-hmm. And it has got a new surface called the canard in the front. This is our first time doing it, but we have good confidence because we already done the wind tunnel tests and the fly-by-wire is capable of...
The canard.
And it has got many new sensors which you can't see. The radar, of course, is indigenous. It's an advanced version of the Uttam radar, which is being tested on LCA right now.
Okay.
It has got IRST, missile approach warning system. So all those advanced sensors which any aircraft, like even the Rafales today... There's nothing less than anything available today internationally that this aircraft will be capable of carrying. And more importantly, it'll carry heavy standoff weapons. That is like the spies, crystal maze, which were used in Balakot.
Yeah.
Those class of weapons this aircraft carries. So it's a much bigger capable aircraft than LCA, but using the technologies which have been matured in LCA.
Okay.
That is why we can project a timeline for this aircraft, which is very ambitious, because all the unknowns are taken away now.
Wow.
Unlike in Tejas.
So this is also going to continue with the laser pods, what we witnessed in the Mark 1?
Continue in this?
The LDPs and the laser pods.
It's much, much more than that.
Much more than that.
Of course, it can carry whatever Mark 1 can carry, but much more.
Okay. So let's now move from Indian Air Force LCA Mark 2 to the fourth stage of the evolution, and this is my favorite. I have been very fascinated with this aircraft, AMCA, and this is something that the Air Force, DRDO, ADA, the HAL and the other verticals and the institutions as far as Make in India and the aviation verticals are concerned, they are working very, very hard on this. So this looks like a fantastic aircraft.
Yeah, it's camouflage paint.
Yeah. How do you explain to our viewers that exactly in terms of the capability, how different this is going to be?
So this is a so-called fifth generation aircraft.
Okay.
LCA Mark 1 and Mark 2 are four and a half generation.
Okay.
Now, you can't convert a fourth generation aircraft into a fifth generation. It has to be an ab initio design. So this is designed for stealth.
Okay.
Stealth is basically the enemy radars should not be able to see this aircraft.
Yeah.
So the shaping and all the aerodynamics is done so that you achieve maximum amount of stealth. And another important thing is it can carry weapons internally.
Wow.
A large amount of weapons can be carried internally. There is an internal weapon bay.
Wow. Where is that?
So right now, it's right here inside. The bay there.
Yeah.
That is the one that can carry a huge amount of weapons.
Yeah.
So it will not carry any weapons externally when it goes in a stealth mode. And it is virtually indetectable to the radar.
Wow.
And only when it has to deploy the weapons, it opens its bay, deploys the weapon and closes it again. So this remains stealthy throughout its operation. This is the initial stages of war. later on, when you have achieved air dominance, it can go in the non-strength mode carrying a huge array of weapons. So this is, and it has got many other features. The intake, for example, is serpentine, so you can't see the engine in face. So many new technologies are developed in this aircraft. The good thing is this design started in 2010.
Okay.
And today the design is complete.
Okay.
Indian Air Force has agreed with the requirement specifications and they have accepted it. So now the go-ahead has come for making AMCA a reality.
Wow.
And it's only a question of now developing this aircraft and practice.
When do we see that rolling out?
Rolling out 24 is planned.
Okay.
And it should happen because already four parts have been made of this aircraft. So
okay.
It's not as just not a dream aircraft. Already four parts are made and the manufacturing has started. So 24 we expect. It's a bigger aircraft and a more challenging aircraft. So 24 is what is planned, the rollout. And by 31, we expect production should start for induction.
Wow. So we are certainly less than a decade away from the fifth generation, India's own, made in India, fifth generation fighter jet AMCA. That is the evolution stage four. And we'll now move to the last one, where basically a lot of excitement is there from the Navy point of view. Let's go and see and exactly understand from Dr. Devdare what is different as far as the Navy's. This is, you see, the twin engine deck-based fighter, the TED-BF for the Indian Navy's, basically for the aircraft carrier operations. We are going to witness the commissioning of INS Vikrant in next few years. And once you have the aircraft carrier, obviously you need the fighter jets. So, Dr. Devdare, how different this is than LCA Mark 1 for the Navy?
Yeah, as I explained, the aircraft behind me, the Mark 1 Navy, was a technology demonstrator to prove capabilities. And the last bastion, as I said, was landing on the carrier. When we achieved that in January 20, now the Indian Navy was convinced that we have the wherewithal and the technologies to make our own carrier-based aircraft, which is a challenging task. And the Navy then came out with the requirement in May 2020 for a twin-engine aircraft for the deck, which obviously has to have folding wings. So it's a big aircraft. It's a replacement for the MiG-29K class of aircraft. So it has a lot of capabilities comparable to that and more than that because it's a more modern aircraft. Many fifth generation capabilities are incorporated in this aircraft, as you can see from the intake and the nose and so on. So this is what is the next one. The concept design is complete and you see it here, the concept design.
Yeah.
And we are moving forwards to the detailed design and freezing the design of this aircraft.
Any timeline set for TED-BF?
By 26, the first flight will happen. That is the timeline set and it will be achieved because again, many of the unknowns are removed now. We know exactly what needs to be done.
Wow. Since the basics are in place and we have already gone through the evolution.
So why LCA was delayed was many technologies were developed parallelly along with the aircraft.
Yes.
And they led to many roadblocks because there were unknowns.
So when do we see in terms of the production? Any expected time?
By about 31-32, the Navy is targeting to have this on the carriers to replace the MiG-29Ks.
Okay.
Yeah, that is the target and it should happen.
Okay. Any word from you, sir, for the NewsX viewers? I experienced LCA, felt proud as an Indian citizen, as an Indian journalist, that we have our own made in India fighter jet. Something that you want to convey to our viewers?
Well, for us, if the user is happy, we are happy, meaning the customer is finally the king. And the most important thing about LCA is whichever pilot has flown it, he comments that its handling quality is so-called, that is the human-machine interface, is one of the best they have flown. And this is not only Indian pilots. Even the foreign pilots who have flown have expressed the same. And this has not happened by chance. The reason this has happened is LCA is a unique program where the Indian Air Force pilots are involved with the design right from day one. We don't have any project pilots. The Indian Air Force provides us with test pilots. These are the top guns of the Indian Air Force who come and sit with us during the design and help us design and fly the aircraft. In fact, our current chief was once a test pilot in ADA. And he has also helped in the design. So many chiefs, vice chiefs, deputy chiefs, assistant chiefs have participated in the design. That's why it's come out so well. Even the naval pilots, they have also participated. So it's a conglomeration of Western, Russian and naval aircrafts. The good parts have been brought together in LCA and of course it carries over in the future platforms as well.
I am not qualified to give any input, but the specific thing that you mentioned as far as the entire vehicle and the men and machine basically interface was fantastic. I've done a bit of simulation.
And by the pilots, for the pilots. Yes, that is the advantage.
Thank you so much, Dr. Devdare. And that's how you see the entire evolution. And with the help of these models, I'm sure you would have got an idea exactly how India's own fighter jet has grown. And it's not just one or two institution, not just one or two person. Yeah, the whole country, and at the same time...
See, this is an effort of ADA, DRDO Labs, CSIR Labs, HAL, and many private industries, MSMEs, who have participated in the design phase also. Not only the manufacturing, which is happening today in HAL, but even during the design, the avionics and so on, many small industries, companies have participated. It's more than 300 such agencies.
300 such
agencies. And they are a vibrant ecosystem now.
Wow.
All these are ready to take up the next challenge, and they have got the expertise now.
So that this is truly, LCA is truly, and all these stages that you see are being developed, truly for India, from India, fighter jet. With cameraman Venkatesh, this is Ashish Singh from Bangalore's Yelahanka Airbase for NewsX.
You know, that last line by Dr. Deodhare was pretty much the most important one. Let me get Group Captain Dr. V.N. Jha into this conversation. Group Captain Jha, here we are, sir. You know, what he just told us is, not only he's told us about the LCA Mark II coming up, but a fifth generation stealth fighter with a total payload capacity to be held internally coming up, a twin engine aircraft coming up for the Navy. But he said that there are more than 300 entities, including MSMEs, that are now not only, forget manufacturing, have been involved at the design phase itself. So not only ADA, DRDO, HAL, but other private sector companies. We are now looking at a jet fleet being manufactured in India over the next decade. If you can hear us, Dr. Jha.
I can hear now. Hello.
Yeah, I had a long-winded question. I'm going to have to repeat myself in case you missed it. We have a jet fleet being manufactured by more than 300 entities, including MSMEs. What does that say about the defense sector in India, sir?
Oh, yes. This is the need of the hour. I mean, it is so delayed. It was in the yesterday decades. Look, you can imagine when a single entity called HAL or ADA has been working there with limited manpower. And you may imagine where there are the plethora of agencies who can work onto the all totally diagonal areas. That is what has been the requirement all through. But nonetheless, Rishabh, let anyone say anything about LCA, but LCA is a state-of-the-art aircraft which has been developed by India, and it is first single platform from where you can take any adversary, you name it. At present, you know, everyone have been very skeptical, and you know, I'm so feeling so glad that I was associated with the indigenized version of the ILSS which DRDO was developing for the LCA. I was a project coordinator in that, but I was a very small body, very small looking at a very small portion of it. But you know, hundreds of the project.
Okay, let's come down to brass tacks. Group Captain Jha, LCA now is going to be up for sale to foreign buyers. We know that interest is done. Do you see this as a frontline fighter, not only for the Indian Air Force, but for other air forces as well?
Oh, yes, it has got, you know, three distinct advantages. Firstly, it is a very small aircraft, leaving a very small signature onto the enemy radars. Secondly, it is yet unknown to the enemies. You know, that's a huge factor in any air operation. If you three, you can know nothing about it, its capability. So today LCA is absolutely not known to the enemy at all. It's absolutely surprise aircraft. And thirdly, it has got the very advanced avionics, which
okay.
Only four.
How is the LCA Mark II going to be even better?
Oh yes. When we were working with the LCA Mark I, we had few problems because, you know, it is a small aircraft, carries lesser fuel, carries lesser payload. So those were the problems. And the surface area underneath the wing panel, where we wanted to say carrying 20 armaments, 20 missiles, it doesn't have that much surface. So we wanted a slightly, you know, wider across section area of the platform.
Okay, so it's going to have greater range and greater armament. Okay, hopefully without losing maneuverability. We know that the Navy twin engine is coming up by 2026 is what the ADA chief has just told us, and commissioned by 2031. That's 10 years from now. We spent 40 years developing Tejas Mark 1. The stealth fighter, sir, latest generation, fifth to sixth generation fighter. What's the time scale we're looking at? What's the reasonable time scale?
See, once we have a fully airborne, fully operational LCA Mark 1, and we shortly will have Mark 1A also, changing the platform, changing the airframe to the stealth doesn't take all those time. You only need a material which can be coated onto the airframe with some.
No, so I think what the ADA chief is saying is that they're doing the design from scratch. This is going to be an absolutely new design, and we got an indication of roughly what it looked like with, of course, the other parameters.
For more such videos, subscribe to the NewsX YouTube channel, hit the bell icon.